The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text number 26, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 15th of April, 1974, in Bombay, India.
Translation. Some of them sacrifice the hearing process and the senses in the fire of the controlled mind, and others sacrifice the objects of the senses, such as sound, in the fire of sacrifice.
Read the purpose.
The four divisions of human life, namely the brahmachari, the grihastha, the vanaprastha, and the sannyasi, are all meant to help men become perfect yogis or transcendentalists. Since human life is not meant for our enjoying sense gratification like the animals, the four orders of human life are so arranged that one may become perfect in spiritual life. The brahmacharis or students under the care of a bona fide spiritual master control the mind by abstaining from sense gratification. They are referred to in this verse as sacrificing the hearing process and the senses in the fire of the controlled mind. A brahmachari hears only words concerning Krishna consciousness. Hearing is the basic principle for understanding, and therefore the pure brahmachari engages fully in Hare Namanu Kirtanam, chanting and hearing the glories of the Lord. He restrains himself from the vibrations of material sound. His hearing is engaged in the transcendental sound vibration of Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Similarly, the householders, who have some license for sense gratification, perform such acts with great restraint. Sex life, intoxication, and meat eating are general tendencies of human society. But a regulated householder does not indulge in unrestricted sex life and other sense gratification. Marriage on principles of religious life is therefore occurrence in all civilized human society, because that is the way for restricted sex life. This restricted, unattached sex life is also a kind of yajna, because the restricted householder sacrifices his general tendency toward sense gratification for higher transcendental life.
Sutradini Indriani Anne Samjamagni Shu Juvati Sabdadin Vishayan Anya Indriagni Shu Juvati. So Indriya Sangyama Yoga. Yoga means Indriya Sangyama. Yoga Indriya Sangyama. The yogic practice is recommended for persons who are too much in the bodily concept of life. Any person. Therefore, this yogic practice was recommended for general population, so that they can control the senses. Gradually, one has to take to this platform of Indriya Sangyama or Satagun, Rajagun, Satagun, and Tamagun. So one has to promote himself to the platform of Satagun. Generally, people are in the Rajas Tamagun. I was explaining yesterday in the morning, Tato Rajas Tamo Bhava Kama Lobha Dayaschaji Cheta Eti Anavidham Sthita Satye Prasidati. Everyone is trying to be very peaceful and happy. That is possible when one is promoted to the platform of Satogun. The yoga practice means that. Yoga practice means by controlling the hairs within the body. That is explained. There are five kinds of air. Vayu. When the hairs are not controlled in old age, according to Ayurvedic system, it is called Vayu Roga. The muscles become slackened, old man, because the air control or air circulation is not proper. There are many medicines, many practices of yoga. So, the real purpose is, yoga practice means to control the senses. Indriyani pararahu, indriyabha param manaha, manasastu parabuddhi, buddhestuja parasra. This is the study of the whole structure. Grossly, our body means the senses. We are everyone, animal and less intelligent man. They are busy only for sense gratification. Indriyani para. They think this sense gratification, this is enjoyment. This is happiness. But actually that is not happiness. Sukham akankitam jattat atindriyani. What is actual happiness? Akankitam. That is atindriya. Atindriya means beyond the senses. But because we have no such knowledge, because we are in the bodily concept of life, I am this body, so I am interested in the matter of gratifying my senses, indriyani parara. Those who are little advanced, they are in the enjoyment of the mind, mental speculation, philosophy, or theosophy. So many zophies are there. Somebody putting some theories, this theory, that theory, that theory. Mental speculation. They derive poetry, writing poetry, nice poetry. They are not on the gross platform of sense gratification, but on the subtle platform of sense. Mind is also sense. Mind is also sense. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Bhumi rapa anara vayu khanga mana buddhi rivata. Binda me pakiti astadha. These eight elements, they are also my prakriti, but bhinna, separated. Separated prakriti. Prakriti means subordinate to the purusha. As soon as the prakriti, generally you understand that the husband and wife is called prakriti, and the husband is called purusha. So purusha means enjoyer, and prakriti means enjoyer. So similarly, when Krishna says, Bhinname prakriti astadha, so all these elements, gross and subtle, earth, water, air, fire, and these are gross elements, and the mind, intelligence, and ego, subtle elements. Then Krishna says, aparayam, these elements are inferior prakriti. Aparayam itastu vidhivi prakritim para. There is another prakriti. What is that? Jiva bhuta mahabaho jayidam dhadyati. Jiva bhuta. The living entity. The living entity is also prakriti. We are not purusha. But we forget this. Prakriti means to be used by the purusha. Therefore our position is, real position is, we should be used by the Supreme Personality of God, Purusha, Purushottam. This is our position. But artificially, we are trying to become the Purusha. That is Maya. Instead of being utilized by the Purusha, we are trying to become the Purusha, to utilize the material nature. Jayidam dhajate jagat. The world is going on, the material world, because the living entities in the attitude of becoming Purusha, they are trying to exploit the resources of this material nature. This is going on. So this is our material disease. And how we are trying to be master or enjoyer of this material world? By the senses, by the mind. Manasasthani prakitisthani karshati. Mana mamaivansa jiva bhuta. The living entities, Krishna says, they are my part and parcel. So, instead of serving Krishna, they are trying to utilizing, they are trying to utilize the material nature for their sense gallery. This is called struggle for existence. Prakitisthani karusat. Karusat is hard struggle. Manasasthani indriyani prakitisthani karusat. This is going on. And this karusati means struggling for existence. Because he cannot be happy. He cannot be happy by this artificial way of life. This is artificial way of life. That's why both of them have been described as prakriti. Vinna me prakriti astadha. And aparan itastu vidri me prakriti para. The para, it is prakriti. Suppose there are two prakritis, two women. One has dressed as man and one has dressed as woman. But how they can enjoy? Because actually they are prakritis. Simply by changing the dress, there is no possibility of enjoy. Prakriti. Therefore, it is simply mental concoction. Mana. Sashtani indriyani prakriti sthani karsati. This is going on. Therefore, those who are too much engrossed in the bodily concept of life, for them this yoga system, then dharana, pranayama, asana, ityadi, different methods, jamyam, but the yoga process also required, sangyam, sangyamagni, it is said, sangyamagni sujuvati. This yoga practice means you have to control the senses, sangyam agni, sacrifice. The spirit of enjoying spirit should be sacrificed in the fire of sangyam. That is required. Samjaga, sangyamagni, sujuvati. Sabdadin, indriyan, anya, indriya, agni, sujuvati. By controlling the senses, Indriyagni. This is also very significant. Indriyagni. Indriyagni that is described in the Narad Pancharat. Rishikena Rishikesa Sevanam Bhakti Ruchyate. Rishik means Indriya. And Rishikesa means Krishna. So, when the indriyas, the senses, will be engaged in the service of the master of the senses, that is indriyagneshu juvati, you cannot control the senses simply by artificial means, by dhyan, dharana, pranayam, jamyam, asana, tyahas. There are so many systems. Big yogis, they fell. Just like Vishwamitra Muni. he was practicing yoga. That Indriya Samyama. He was specially, because he was king, so specially he was very sexually inclined. And the yoga process, he was trying to control the sex. But what was the result? The result was that Menaka, a society girl of the hymn, she appeared and she was trundling there. There have been many instances like that, and tinkling of the bangles, or immediately his yoga practice was broken. And he began attacked by Menaka, and there was birth of Shakuntala. There is a drama written by Kalidas Kavi, Shakuntala. This is the subject matter. How a yogi failed to control his senses and was attacked by a beautiful woman girl, and how Shakuntala, the beautiful girl, was born. That is the subject matter. So, this is sometimes impossible. There are many, many instances. So this is artificial way of yoga system. But when actually, as it is recommended, sabdadin indriyani anna indriyagneshu yuvati. That indriyagneshu means the indriya of Krishna. When he satisfies the indriyas, the senses of Krishna, then automatically our indriyas become satisfied, engaged. There is another verse written by Prabhudananda Saraswati. He says, Kaivallam narakayate tidasapura akasa puspayate Duddhanta indriya kala sattva patali prutkhata damastraya. Prutkhata damastraya. Just like dentist, when there is some pain in the teeth, they extract. That is called prutkhata, extract. So, the indriyas have been compared with kala sattva. Kala sattva. Many venomous snake. As soon as the kala sattva or snake touches in any part of your body, because the venomous teeth is there, death is there immediately. Therefore, it's called kala sattva. Kala means death. Kala sattva. Therefore, you are so much afraid of a snake. So, but if the kala sattva's poison teeth is taken away, then it is no more, fearful. It is no more dangerous. Therefore, Prabhudananda Saraswati says that by the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, our indriyas, the senses which are compared with the kala sattva, may be kala sattva, but the poison teeth is extracted. Duddhanta indriya kala sattva patali pratkhata dhamastayat. So that is bhakti yoga process. Indriyas cannot be, controlled, unless you engage your indriyas in the service of the master of indriya. That is called bhakti yoga. Sarvapadhi vinirmuktam tatparatena nirmalam. If you want to purify your indriyas, then you have to accept to be free from the upadhi. At the present moment, because we are in bodily concept of life, I am thinking that I belong to this family. So, if I do not satisfy the family members, I have to satisfy. This is my real position. Jive Swarupa Nitya Krishna Das. My position is servant of Krishna. That is my constitutional position. Krishna means to serve Krishna's desire. What Krishna says, as Krishna says, Sarvadhamman Parikrajamanakal, his demand. But if we do not do that, that means we are not willing to serve Krishna, then my position is serve, to serve. Then I have to serve in my designation. I am the master of this family, I am the belong to this society, to this nation, to this, that, so many. Griha Chetra Sutapta Vittai Janasamuho. Illusory master. You have to serve. Because you have to serve. So these indriyas, unless they are purified by becoming without any designation. Just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, I am not a Brahmin, I am not a sannyasi, I am not a Kshatriya, I am not a Brahmachari, because these are designations. Varnasam dharma, four varnas and four ashramas. Of course now, we do not know even this designation. We are simply animals at the present moment. Ahara nidra vayamaita. But human society means to divide the whole human society into these eight divisions. Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanaprastha. Then it is systematic. But you have to go above that. That systematic division of the society is also sense gratification. That is not real life. That is also sense gratification. But it is systematized. Just like as several times the marriage is sense gratification, sex life. But somebody may say, they say that marriage legalized prostitution. It may be, but still there is some control. Although it is called legalized prostitution, there is no difference between prostitution and married life. But there is some control. People become responsible. By responsible life, they can make advance. Irresponsible life will not help. Therefore, loke babayami samadva siva nittartha jantu. So, our tendency for sense gratification is control. That's what is called license. Grihastha life means a license for sense gratification. But we must know that sense gratification means material life. It may be systematic or not systematic. Sense gratification means material life. But our aim is to transcend this material life and come to the spiritual life, platform of spiritual life. That is required. So there are so many processes. So that is being discussed by Krishna. Here he is specially referring to the mystic Jova system. Indriyagneshu Juvati, controlling the senses. So, this controlling the senses, the simple method is that artificially if you want to practice Jova, like Vishwamitra Muni or Dubbhasamuni, very great depth. There are many big stories about this Muni, where big yogis, this Dubbhasamuni, traveled all over the universe, and he went beyond the universe, in the spiritual world. He saw Lord Vishnu personally. Still, he was defeated. There are many stories. Ambarish Maharaj. So, these indriyas cannot be controlled. Duddhanta indriya kala sattva patali. But these indriyas cannot do any harm to you if you take the poison teeth of this deadly snake, poison teeth. Indya Kala Sattva Pratalipatthana. What is that? What is the process of taking away the poison tea? That is Bhakti Yoga. That is Bhakti Yoga. That means Sarva Badhi Vininmuktam Tatparatina Ninman Rishikena. Rishik means India. Rishikesa Sevara. You cannot control the senses unless you engage your senses in the service of the senses of the Lord. The Lord has got senses. He is also a living being, like us, but a less intelligent class. They cannot understand. They think that something must be opposite. No. The basic information is Nitya Nityana, the Absolute, Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is also eternal. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. So Bhagavan says that Arjuna, you and me and all these people who have gathered here, we are Nitya. We were present in the past, and we are now in the battlefield, and when we give up this body, we shall again remain the same. Individual. That is explained in the second chapter. This individuality continues. There is no such information that all of them become one by amalgamation. Not possible. Because in the Bhagavad Gita, Mamaimamsa Jiva Bhuta Jiva Loke Sanatana Amsa, the particles of the Supreme, they are Sanatana. It is not that by chance the spirit, whole spirit, has been broken into pieces. No, that is not possible. Because in the Bhagavad Gita I find Achidram. It cannot be broken into pieces. Then how will it become pieces? Therefore, these piecemeal, these small particles of the original whole, they are sanatana. It is not that by circumstance it has become small. No. And when they amalgamate, just like they give the example that the water, when it is put into the water, again it becomes one. But scientifically, they are molecules. They remain separate. Even the sun sign, they are simply combination of shining molecules. Similarly, we are also like that. Shining, spiritual molecules. So, sanatana. These particles are sanatana. So they must have engagement. Because we small particles are the Supreme, we are also engaged. Krishna, Bhuliyaji, Bhagavan, we are engaged in material affairs. So our business is to finish this material affair and not to be attracted by the material affairs, but to be attracted by the spiritual affairs. That is not that finishing. It cannot be finished. That one in the Shastra says, Jannera Vinnakha Vimukta Marina Tayyasta Bhavada Vishuddha Buddha. Those who are thinking that now we have Brahma Gyan, knowledge, and we have become one with Brahma, therefore we are now liberated. Vimukta Marina. That is not liberation. The liberation is not there because because these senses are not yet engaged in the service of the Lord. They do not know the personality of Tai Astubhava, Avishuddha Buddhaya. They cannot be liberated. Why not? They have already become liberated. No. Arajya Kripchena Param Padam Tataha Patanti Adha Anadita Jismadanghaya. Arajya, they have undergone severe penances, austerity, that is right. And they have come to the parampada, Brahmapada. But patanti adho, because Anandamaya Vyasa, everyone wants Ananda, and part and parcel of Ananda, Krishna, he wants Ananda. The simply realization, Aham Brahmasmi, will not stay. Because simply knowing I am such and such, simply knowing that I am a millionaire, or simply knowing that I am a big man, that will not help him. He must have some activities. Anandamaya Vyasat. Vyasat means there must be activities. If you stop activities, there will be no ananda. Then you will again search out where is activities. And because you have no spiritual activities, you will come down with the material activities. So this artificial type of some jamagni issue, jivati, it may help you for the time being to stop the activities of the indriya, but that will not be permanently. Therefore, this process, that sarvabhadi vinirmaktam tatparatena nirmana, when you become free from all designation, as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, I was going to explain, that I am not a Brahmin, I am not a Shudra, I am not a Kshatriya, I am not a Vaishya, I am not, this is negation. Then what you are? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Bhopi Bhaktu Padakamalayo Dasa Dasa Anu Dasa. There is activities. As soon as you accept Dasa Dasa Anu Dasa, there must be activities. Dasa has got activities. So, see, Dasa, when these activities are there, and then Rishikena Rishikesa Sevanam Bhakti Ruchyate. That is called Bhakti. If you adopt this means to engage the senses in the service of the master of the senses, we possess some senses, but we are not master. Suppose I have got this touch sense hand, I am working with, but I actually am not master. If the hand is paralyzed, you cannot work. So how you can be master of the senses? It is dependent on something else. The master of senses, when Krishna says, Sadhutu Pani Padasta, Krishna has got hands and legs everywhere. Or Brahma has got hands and legs. What is that hand? Your hand, my hand, is the Brahma's hand. Because you are part and parcel of Brahma. So, now your hands and legs are engaged in upadhi. Everyone is working. I am American, I am Indian, I am Brahman, I am Sudra, I am this family's head, this, that, all that. So you have to forget this, that I don't belong to this material world. I am so nice division. Either we call Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, American, Indian, this, that. No. Purely I am spirit soul, and my business is to serve Krishna. Then you'll be able to control your senses, because senses want engagement. If you artificially stop, it will not stay. For the time being, it may be appear, but it is not possible. You cannot be desireless. Sometimes we say that we should be desireless. That is not possible. When you are desireless, then you are a dead man. That is not possible. The whole process should be purifying desire. Purifying desire. Mind. Mind is the source of desires. Therefore, the bhakti process is, first of all, engage the mind. Sabai mana krishna padaravindayo. If you engage your mind, always thinking of Krishna, Malvana Bhavamad Bhakta Madhyaji Mahanamaskuru. This is the recommendation given by Krishna. So if you first of all engage your mind to the lotus feet of Krishna, then Krishna says, you become first class yogi. Yogi Namati Sarvesam Madhgata Antanatma Sadhyavan Bhajati Juman Samejitta Tamova. He is first class yogi. who is always engaged in thinking of Krishna's lotus feet, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama. That is first class yogi. Then you perfect this yogic process, Indriya Agni Suju Bhati, in the senses of Krishna, in the fire of Krishna's senses, when he engages, you cooperate with the Indriya, that is your perfect life. Thank you very much.